Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. We have already completed up to question 30 of 2018-19 NSO paper set C for class 6. Today we are going to start from question 31. So let's get started. Question 31. What is a common character of the above shown animals? Look at the pictures. The correct answer will be option B. They all lack backbone. In the given pictures, amoeba is a protist, ant, spider, octopus and starfish are invertebrates, so they all lack backbones. So the correct answer will be option B. Now question 32. Refer to the given relationship and select the option that satisfies the same relationship. Pumice, sandstone, gneiss. Pumice is a igneous rock, sandstone is a sedimentary rock, and gneiss is a metamorphic rock. Now look at option A. Obsidian. Obsidian is a igneous rock. Conglomerate. This is a sedimentary rock and slate is a metamorphic rock. So the correct answer will be option A. Obsidian, conglomerate and slate. Now question 33. Refer to the given flowchart and select the correct option. Sources of fibers. Plants, animals. Plants obtained from stem W, obtained from fruit X. Animals, animal is killed Y, animal is not killed Z. So according to the flowchart, W, X, Y and Z could be flax or jute, cotton, silk and wool respectively. So the correct answer will be option C, W, flax and Z, wool. Now question 34. Refer to the given flowchart and select the correct option regarding P, Q, R and S. It is an edible item obtained from producers. If yes, it is obtained from stem. If yes, it is obtained from underground stem. If no, yes. If yes, R. It is obtained from stem. If no, it is obtained from flowers. If yes, Q. If no, P. According to the flowchart given here, R could be potato or ginger as they have modified underground stems. S could be sugarcane or asparagus as they are stem grown above the ground. Cauliflower and broccoli are flowers. Tomato and okra are fruits. Sweet potato and radish are modified roots. Cumin and fennel are seeds, turmeric and jamikant are stems and fenugreek and spinach are leaves. So the correct answer will be option A. R could be potato or ginger whereas S could be sugarcane or asparagus. Question number 35. The given graph depicts two different methods of disposal of biodegradable solid waste. What can be inferred from the given graph? Look at the graph. According to the given graph, process X is composting and process Y is incineration. Look at the options. The correct answer will be option D, that is all of these. Now question 36. Refer to the given table and select the correct statement for K to P. Plant part, function and examples are given. Ivy is a climber plant and climbs with the help of its roots. Begonia reproduces vegetatively with the help of its leaves. In pea plant leaf, tendrils help in climbing And in Opuntia, the stem stores water. In ginger, the stem is modified to store food. And in grapevine, stem tendrils help it to climb. In Nepenthes, leaf forms pitcher. And in Dionae, the leaf forms a trapping structure. So the correct answer will be option A. L could be Ivy, whereas O could be Begonia. Question 37. Which of the following actions will help in reducing pollution? I. Using induction cooktops instead of LPG stove for cooking food. This is the correct option. Statement 2I. Using unleaded petrol in cars. This is also the correct option. Statement 3I. Spraying pesticides on plants to kill pests. This is the incorrect statement. Statement IV. Carrying cotton or jute bags for shopping instead of poly bags. This is also the correct statement. So the correct answer will be option D. I, 2I and IV only. Now question 38. What does the given image depict about rise of liquid in the straw? Read the options carefully. When the boy sucks air present in the straw, the pressure falls down inside, causing the liquid to rise up. So the answer will be option B. Now question 39. Refer to the given flowchart. Select the option that correctly identifies P, Q and R. Plant with taproot system. If yes, it is a hub. If yes, P. If no, Q. Plant with taproot system. If no, R. Coriander is a hub with taproot system. Hibiscus is a shrub with taproot system. And banana is a monocot with fibrous root system. So the correct answer will be option B. P will be coriander, Q hibiscus and R banana. Now question 40. Refer to the given Venn diagram and select the correct option. According to the Venn diagram, P could be both animal having scales as outer body covering and animal having endoskeleton of bones. Q will be animal having scales as outer body covering only, and R will be having animal having endoskeleton of bones. So the correct answer will be option C. P will be seahorse, Q will be butterfly and R will be frog. Thanks for watching.